I've posted movie suggestions. I don't know if they'll be your thing, but
I'll check it out later. Right now, my focus is on the art stream. So let me see.
Yeah, no, I gotcha.
All right. So I'm gonna be drawing Ratigan here.
Nice.
Picking up where I left off on the previous stream, which is up.
I'll be back in just a sec.
Gotcha. All right. So for those just attending, as I'm recording right now, I'm starting to branch out into artwork streams. The last one, as you can see here, involved Patrick. And there were two other characters that several users from the Great Mouse Detective Discord have permitted me to draw. This one is basically going to be Patrick meeting Professor Ratigan from Disney's Great Mouse Detective. The music has been lowered to avoid copyright, but you know how YouTube is. All right, so let me see here. I'm trying to think of the right pose. Let me try and get the... All right, let's see here. Let me get this out of the way. Ratigan's got a unique body shape. All right. I don't know if it's because of my monitor, but it's hard to see his color, so I might kind of brighten it up a little bit. Let me see here. Symbol. Let's do that. And filter, adjust color. Let's put the brightness up just a smidge there so you can see a little better. There you go. Alright. Now I'm going to get his face again. So let's see. Alright. So I'm thinking. Usually my process is that I like to go through it a few times until I get it just right, you know? I think he should have, like, his grin, like his evil grin as he's doing this. There you go. He's got that right here, like that. So for those that were just attending the new stream, the idea, the creation behind Patrick was that he was a MySpace character. There was a roleplay scene back on MySpace, and we used to do like cartoon characters and things like that. It was our own little niche. Message boards were still a thing that I used to do as well, but okay, his nose goes downward. I wasn't role-playing as Patrick per se. It was more like I was actually role-playing as Professor Ratigan. And, Patrick was a NPC, kind of jobber-type character that was just introduced through text. And, so I was mostly role-playing as Ratigan, and we had a Basil, and we had a... There was someone else there that also did other characters, like original characters. And, but yeah, the story that he became popular because people liked how I was playing as him, and he had his own unique storyline. And ultimately, you know, before MySpace died, you know, I would have, you know, made an account for him and started drawing artwork for him, but... You know, so he was basically Ratigan's jobber. You know, he was a petty thug, but his whole shtick was that, sorry, I'm getting tongue-tied here, because it's my friend Mikey's birthday, or maybe it was yesterday or today, either way. There's going to be a VR chat party in a few hours, so once this is over, I'm going to be attending that with my friends. There we go. I'll shorten this over here. This is basically what I do. I like to... there you go. I don't know if the music bot is going... I tried to put this on the music bot, But the AEO'd won't play it, probably because, I don't know, YouTube is dumb. That's just how it is. There he goes. Yeah, he was a no-name jobber to Patrick. Yeah, he was a no-name jobber to Ratigan. Playing as Ratigan was actually kind of fascinating, because there was one really good storyline that we did where we came up with a reason why Ratigan was a huge dude. Not because he was a rat, but it's like there was a kind of like a little explanation why we had Ratigan be his size. The idea being that it was the result of, it was like a tie-in to H.G. Wells's, sorry, I'm coughing up the storm today. The idea being that the result of his size was through science, like Jekyll and Hyde. Like he was a student at the university had kind of like the hots for one of his the college professor teachers, and they wound up going on of he would actually go there to, you know, the teacher understood that he had a thing against her other student, Basil, so it would take him in, and they would study together and, you know, become fast friends about science and duality, like in the Jekyll and Hyde books and all that. And ultimately, the science gone bad turned him into a hulking beast. So this, we gave the explanation that he would be the Hyde to his other self's Jekyll. You know, and I actually have art of that I preserved before MySpace died, thank God. Because Justin Timberlake and Rupert Murdoch or whoever took over MySpace is a dumbass. yeah. I should have, like, he leans in closer, like, he's just kind of like, Patrick, my old friend, how long has it been? It's like, Patrick, listen here, buddy. I've been following you. Since when did you become the local celebrity, my old friend? You know, let me see. Alright. Yeah, but good times on MySpace, you know, we had a lot of fun. I don't remember if I did anything with the Basil role player, but I definitely did stuff with people behind the scenes. And like I said, this is the birth of Patrick. So Patrick basically came NPC, and he was about to get his own account before MySpace died. His whole stick of looking like Basil and doing Ratigan's dirty deeds, while, you know, he could have impersonated Basil and got away with murder and things like that, and frame him. So he had, you know, he was one of Ratigan's best hires, you might say. He found him. He discovered him like an agent, you know? I feel like I should pull him in closer. Like, or maybe, that. Have him, like, breathing down Patrick's face like that, with that schnoz. Alright, so let's do this. Did somebody poke me on there? Okay. But yeah, it was a good time back then, back in the MySpace. Final Draft, if you want, I can check your messages on the Aaron's Art Stream channel. So if you want to chat for me there, you can use your mic if you want. I don't mind. I will have to tell my client that I'm streaming right now, because it's like he's, alright, I have a client that wants to talk shop. I got about 2 hours before Mikey's VR chat birthday go down, so I'm cool with that. Alright, so let's move, I don't know if I'll do the backgrounds on this one. I'll just kind of leave it blank. Maybe I'll I won't put that on the stream because I'm not really good at backgrounds. Like, people are going to be like, oh, that's lazy. You know, so it's like, all right. Backgrounds are stuff I want to take my time on, and that would be a very boring video. So, but, yeah, I love...
Oh, nice, you're drawing Ratigan.
Hey, hello. Hello, who joined?
It's Wes.
Hey, Wes, how's it going?
Good.
Cool, cool. I'm branching out into art streams for my YouTube channel, and I want to, like...
Nice.
Yeah, I figured I want to do something unique. I was going to do Mice Tea today, but, like, Mikey's birthday party is coming up. Like, it's been, like... It's like I want to play, but then like either something comes up or I'm not like well, so it's like damn, I gotta find time to do. Oh, Ratigan's song just kicked in now on my YouTube right now. The bot couldn't play it, so I was like I got it on the side. So Ratigan's singing, Oh Ratigan.
Nice.
Yeah, I'm trying to find the right balance. It's like a curved. Pointed shape, so it's like it'd be like there, and that'll do it. But as I was explaining earlier, basically, I'll be doing some requests from some GMD fans because I'm on a Disney GMD server. Wes, you might know the person behind it, it's the one that did a commission for you. They're hosting it, you can ask them to join if you haven't already. They're really nice people. There's a couple of people there that I took some requests from, and I don't know how often I'll be able to do the streams. Like this one took like at least a week or two to kind of like find the time, because we're always busy. We're always playing games or the commissions, like your commission or you know somebody else's. Like even Ecat is like he wants to discuss like a sequel to the comic he got, and But yeah, I will try to make a habit of this because it was something one of my techs guys said too. He's like, hey, you know, if you want your channel to grow, you should even do some artwork stuff like that. I'm like, all right, that's actually a good idea. I haven't thought about that. Or it's like I've been meaning to, but it's like I don't know how many people would actually show up and attend. And there we go. I mean, a little too pointed, too bumpy. Let's go like that. But let me see. I really liked role playing as Ratigan. I don't know if I could do a good job with him now because I haven't seen the movie in God knows how long. But I'm always on the hunt for like a good message board role play. I don't know if Discord would really do it justice. I think because like I always like that method in. In message boards where you could just kind of like you sign up as the character, you give him the avatar, and you can make multiple characters, you know, like a multiverse kind of thing. That was my method.
Oh, nice.
Yeah. That's cool. There was one message board I was going to join, and I had like some choices of characters I wanted to play as. I wanted to play as Ratigan and or Basil, and then maybe like Chip from Chip and Dale. But they were taken. And then I found like a Discord one. I did find a Discord version of that particular group. The thing is that a lot of people there were either like, I kind of want to say like too young. So I was like, yeah, I'm out of there. Cause I was like, yeah, I don't. I mean, it sounds wrong when I say it like that. The best way to start is, like, you got, like, the admin is, like, 30, then there's me who's, like, 35, and there's, like, a couple people that are, like, you know, 20, 27, but it's, like, the rest are, like, you know, newcomers into the role-playing thing. I'm like, yeah, I'm out of there. It's, like, it could have been a lot of fun, but there was a gap in, like, the people participating. Like, they did have dedicated threads to, you know, hang out. You know, you had the kingdom, you had, places from Kingdom Hearts, like things like that. I was like, all right, but I was like, yeah, probably would have been cool, but nah. Nothing's gonna really take away from the message board experience. There we go. Ratigan is just like, ah, Patrick, my fellow criminal, how long has it been? You know, he would just be like, I heard you made the paper today. Or something like that. It's like, oh, you are leaving a paper trail. Are you getting sloppy? You know, or something like that. Let me see here. I keep forgetting that they're on a different layer. Maybe I should bring these over to the... There we go. Oh, God, yeah, all right. So how you been, Wes? How you hanging out? Or how you doing these days? Hopefully you're doing better, because I heard you had a lot of stuff going on. How about you, Final Draft? You doing all right?
Yeah, I'm doing well. I'm just taking it easy.
Oh, man. I think you probably would have liked last night's wrestling stream, if I had to be honest. Like, all right, let me close Patrick's thing down. I think you would have dug it. It was pretty wild. I'm trying to think what the results are in the pro wrestling section if you want to check that out. All right.
Check it out at some point.
Yeah.
Moment.
And I might get WWE 2K23, so we can always play that. When you have the time.
I'm definitely gonna need to remake Final Draft, Rough Draft, Chin Lee, and the Six.
Yeah. I'll still be streaming 2K22, mostly because I want to at least bring that game some closure. Because we made all these arenas and we haven't really been able to, you know, to showcase them. Yeah. And
actually,
so
on that note,
I was
thinking that the Six could actually appear in 2K23. Like, we showed the preview with Scree Avatar in 2K22, but I feel that we should wait until we start doing the 2K23 streams before the Six actually get a proper appearance.
Right. That the storyline that you want that we were working on together, that can still happen. We put that on hold so we could do a tag team tournament, which is actually, I was gonna bring it up. It came out really good. The first match was we put Seth Rollins and Bobby Lashley against Cryptic's character, Adrian Black, who looks like kind of like Finn Balor. He looks like a demon with all these tattoos and stuff. Really good design. And Diablo Blanco, which is Rocky's biggest, buffest, like luchador type guy. And that match was actually very competitive. The AI pulled out a really strong banger. Like, that one could have gone either way. But the highlight of the night, though, was... I will say this, though. If I wind up taking longer than 2 hours, I'll just say, hey, I'll pick it up after the VR chat birthday party. But going back to what I was saying, we put our Power Rangers characters up against two Capcom characters... who were one of them's named Titanic Tim, which is silly, but you know, it was the 90s. And the other one was Birdie from Street Fighter. And that match is worth it. I will link that to you guys when it goes live on Monday, that particular scene. I don't know if I showed you the that video. But it was, I think I made his cheeks too. I think maybe I should tone down the cheeks here. Or maybe, I don't know. Maybe extend. I'll tinker this in the next stream if I go overboard. There's a clip I might have sent you and a couple other people. I called it the Spinebuster Heard Round the World because he was lifting up a seven, Power Rangers. My Power Rangers character turned 2K22 wrestler. He lifted up a 7-foot-tall giant and hit him with the spine buster. It was massive. It was just like... let me see. I feel like I should extend it like, I don't know what you guys think. Should I like extend it like right here? So I'm looking at this. Maybe I should find like another image, but let me see that. I also feel like
Looks good as is, pretty much.
Okay. Or let me just bring those cheeks down to here. Okay. Because I got to take into factor his neck, too. So let me see here. But,
yeah, he does kind of have a fat neck.
Yeah. This one's, like, wrapped around his neck like that. So let me, like, that-ish. There you go. You know, Wes, if you want, I know I should be working on your commission, but if you want, if this kind of turns out to go, if this goes relatively well, would you like me to draw Mary Mouse, your opera singer? I don't know if he's still in the chat or not.
Oh, he left the VC.
Oh, damn, okay. I wouldn't mind drawing his Mary Mouse character, because... that's a character that he and I have been like quietly like shipping together. like Beverly and his opera singer, Mary. All right.
Okay, that's cute. I gotta see that.
Yeah, if you're familiar with Mary, it's she's like an opera singer who has like actually, you know what? I think in terms that we can both understand, or both like relate to, think Dulce Dragon, but as a mouse.
Okay, that is just friggin' cute. I gotta see.
Yeah, we've even like role played it together. It's the idea was that she has this ability to hit really really high notes, and it's it's like, yeah, I like that a lot. But
I get what you mean.
Yeah. All right.
Also, I'm sorry if you hear stuff in the background. My brother's got the radio on.
I can't even hear it. I lowered your mic just a smidge because I wanted to leave the music on in the background because I also have YouTube playing. So it's like, yeah, if there's any audio from like your brother, family, or anything like that, it's like I can't hear it because I got the. You know, Basil's action music playing in the background. So you're good, bro. You're good. You're all fine. All right.
You know, actually going back to the WWE, I do have an idea for three more fighters.
Really?
These would actually be based off of a story that I started writing a while ago called Impetus.
Sounds interesting. Could work.
Yeah, in my story of Impetus, there the three main characters are all dead. They're ghosts, but they're ghosts with like they're ghosts with very reasons to try to leave the world of the living. For example, the main character he's working for the Grim Reaper, so he liberates souls on his behalf.
Interesting.
The second character is a girl. She is a vengeful spirit. Basically along the lines of, say, Ju-on the Grudge or Ringu. Her main goal is to basically kill the one who killed her so that she can finally be at rest.
Right.
And then finally is a guy who... He's been dead for over 300 years, but his soul is fractured. His main goal is to recover the missing pieces of his soul so that he can move on.
Okay.
Yeah. Also, each character is dressed according to how they died. For example, the main guy, he was basically in everyday clothes when he got hit by a car. The girl, she was walking home from school when she was walking home from school when she was murdered. And then finally the third guy, he was a samurai when he was alive.
Okay.
Yeah.
It sounds like it could be kind of fun to do.
Yeah. The story itself is still in the planning phase, but overall, I was thinking of creating the characters as wrestlers for WWE.
Yeah, if you want. I will admit, I try to avoid making fantasy characters in my games. Sometimes a lot of the stuff I bring in mostly just versions of my old friends, because there were, back then in the 90s, WWE was such a big, big thing. So I try to characters like
I'm aware.
Characters like the Almighty George was like a joke character and things like that, but I like to bring in all my buddies along, and I should show you how I turned my friend Jeff into a pretty unstoppable. Did you see that one video I put up of Ari-Dynamic fighting Jeff Riley?
Yes, I saw that one.
God, that was a tough battle, because not even just for the fact that the HUD was off, but I feel like the AI broke halfway in, and he just starts beating me to death with a baseball bat for a solid minute and a half. I was like, dude,
That's funny that the AI broke that way.
Yeah, it happened three times, too, and I'm like, how the fuck am I supposed to get out of here? It's like, I had to resort to just constantly putting him in the submission hold, because I couldn't even fucking get out. It was like, goddamn. But,
ludicrous. How the hell does the AI break that bad?
Good question. I have no idea. It had to have taken, the parameters into account and just, I don't know, just fucking wrecked it. Or just, it's like, okay, it's oh, yeah, I set Jeff Riley to aggressive 90%. I was like, oh, you want aggressive? Okay, I'll give you aggressive. And just had him just beat the shit out of me. Oh, my God.
That in and of itself reminds me of that Cat Icarus put into one of his videos when he was talking about a hilariously bad Find the Hidden Things game. He said the game probably broke and sent him back to the previous level.
Oh, Lord. Also, Miss Kitty Mouse's theme is playing right now. Oh, God. You know what? I think we're going to, if this goes well, we have to, I guess I'll draw Miss Kitty Mouse, but, I'm going to, if it gets to Miss Kitty, if this video goes well, if it goes fairly well, if it brings in some views and people like it, I will draw Miss Kitty Mouse. I'll draw a Miss Kitty Mouse with Beverly or Vinny. Maybe Vinny. Mm-hmm. Maybe she could be flirting with Vinny or something like that, while Bever's just like, huh? Bever's like, what's she got that I don't got?
She's giving her that look.
Yeah, the concerned wife look. The Marge Simpson stare.
Yeah, maybe even doing the groan, just.
I'll see how far I get into this picture.
Oh God, that reminded me of one of the best jokes in The Simpsons, when Homer was wearing a T-shirt with Marge's smeared face
on it. I remember that. Yeah.
It's a sign.
Oh, God.
It's a sign.
See, I think this should be bigger. Let's see here. Let's see, I don't know if I should make it big, into his teeth, or maybe
Isn't that Pels?
Yeah. Let's see. I really do want to. I really do want to do a comic with Ratigan and Patrick on the side. It would be a nice little tip of the hat to its inspiration.
Yeah, I love Ratigan's expression. He's a smug son of a bitch.
Yeah, I was explaining earlier, it would just be the story behind this picture. I think would be something along the lines of Patrick is getting these mysterious letters right? He's getting like these Riddler-esque letters, and Vinny is the first one to find them. But he keeps this secret from Patrick because he's like, he's not sure. He wants to kind of figure things out on his own. So Vinny does like his own detective work about these mysterious letters. And, ultimately it gets him captured as a result. So when Patrick finds them, he's like, all right, I don't know where Vinny is. He couldn't have skipped town. So he does the legwork. He starts making connections, looking for things. And it ultimately leads him to Ratigan. And Ratigan, he finds Ratigan, warehouse, somewhere mysterious, like somewhere where they can just confront each other personally. And there he reveals himself, and it's like a blast from the past, and it cuts to, like, another Ratigan track is playing right now, how appropriate. But nice. Patrick, you don't remember me, your agent, your fellow companion, your employer, or something like that, and it cuts to...
I love Patrick's expression right there. He's like, I don't trust you, asshole.
Yeah, he's like, is Vinny... One of the rare times he would be like, is Vinny okay? Like, who else have you captured? And, like, Vinny is, like, probably, like... He's trapped in, like, a box, and he's, like... somewhere where, like, there's rabid dogs, like, above him or below him or something like that. It's just, like, very Joker-esque in a way, or just, like, Batman, like, but, yeah. It would cut to, like, a scene where young Patrick he's looking for odd jobs, like a sense of direction as a petty thief before he goes solo, and, Ratigan takes him in and gives him, like, these odd jobs, like harassing police, and before Patrick flies solo, and Ratigan's just like, ah, yes, I'm here to collect my payment. You've never paid me when you worked for me, or something like that. Mm-hmm. And then it's like, well, if I can't get the money out of you, I'll take something from you, someone you love. It's like, and then it's Vinny. Maybe I don't think he'd go. I don't think he'd meddle with Beverly, but Beverly would kind of be aware. Maybe with like her association her association would probably be like Ratigan was a business partner, but she never knew it was him because he was like under an alias at the time, like her father was like. Some kind of like supplier without realizing, like Ratigan used an alias to supply like the something in their business,
and never appeared in person.
Yeah, it was just a name on a spreadsheet until Beverly finally put two and two together and all that.
So, yeah, like, that is actually a pretty interesting concept.
Yeah, trying to get the position, because his chest has to be like pushing up against Patrick or something, like, or reeling him in. Whatever I don't finish, I'll pick up tomorrow. Like, I'm pretty slow when it comes to artwork. I have to be in like
worries. I mean, it's a completely understandable time with things they like.
Yeah,
I mean hell if I ever come down to it, I can show you my progress with one of my projects.
Yeah, all right, so it's like something in the middle here.
Actually, on that note, I should probably get some homework done so I could continue.
That movie you recommended, like, I hope I wasn't rude when I tried to say that to you. Like, I didn't want to come off like, oh, you picked some weird ass movie. Like, it was more like, I don't know if I want to watch a movie with like high intense like gore or anything like X Game.
I get what you mean. I admit it's probably because I grew up watching a whole bunch of weird movies to begin with.
Yeah, it's like the other guys might want to see it. You could try poking around and seeing if they do, but for me, it's like, I don't know. For me, I kind of want to like introduce the group to some mainstream movies, like Back to the Future. Obviously, I think Zach's gonna try and He's gonna host like the first Back to the Future movie, and I'll pitch in and do like a little stream like parts 2 and 3 from Back to the Future. And we can throw in some unique movies in there later, like once we've seen all the more well known movies, like, you know, Back to the Future, Terminator, Jurassic Park, whatever. And then we could throw in like that or Skinamarink and whatever.
Hell, we could even throw in some Cronenberg.
Vinny, Vinny's gonna like that. No, I meant the Vinders. I might kind of like that. I don't think he's into David, but I've heard him like. I'll bring it up to him, see if he'd be down for that. We'll do like a group.
Yeah,
poll.
I've also got some Lynch movies. I haven't seen a. I've got David Lynch's first movie, Eraserhead.
Oh man, yeah, I've heard Eraserhead's a very surreal movie.
It is. Yeah, based on what I've seen, like trailers and clips, is bizarre. Like, one thing I love about Lynch specifically is that a lot of his works, they feel like dreams almost.
Yeah, that's the impression I got from what I've seen of Eraserhead. It's very surreal, dreamlike. You know, you could tell the director must have been leaning into some stuff he wrote in like a dream journal, because it's so weird.
Yeah, same with Twin Peaks, actually, because with almost everything in that that's weird, it seems very dreamy.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden I remember how some people call Neil Breen the David Lynch of bad movies. You heard of Neil Breen, I presume?
No, I can't say I have, no.
Okay, Neil Breen is known for making just a bunch of weird movies that make absolutely no sense.
So is he good though, or is he like Tommy Wiseau?
Remember what I said, that that Neil Breen is seen as the David Lynch of bad movies. Well, compare that to Tommy Wiseau, who's called the Orson Welles of bad movies.
Oh Jesus! Wow. Damn, Ratigan's got some thick ass arms. He's got some fucking meat on them bones. All right.
They're fucking thick.
This kind of cements this kind of complements why when I roleplayed as him on MySpace, we did this Jekyll and Hyde story with him. It's like it's not purely because, you know, he looks like a rat. We came up with the idea that the reason why he's so fucking dummy thick is the that's gonna be a thing in his own. The reason why he looks so mass bulky like is because of Jekyll and Hyde thing that we were doing.
You wanted to give him a kind of like a an extraordinary gentleman Jekyll and Hyde, where
I love those fucking comics. I based Sven's redesign inspired by. It's obviously, when you look at Sven's model sheet, I'll even load that up right now, actually. The, where's the Keeping Up with Thursday folder? Like, where is it? Model sheets, okay, Miranda, Pat, Finn, Vince. Yeah, this has the Ratigan influence. It doesn't quite look like it, but I think so in these areas, he would have, like, some, he's inspired by the LXG, or League of Extraordinary Gentlemen comic book, not the movie, that version of Hyde. Like, I love Alan Moore's comic books so fucking much. Like,
yeah, I've actually been wanting to read the original League of Extraordinary Gentlemen. I hear it's a friggin' amazing story.
Very much, man. And that, like, all the characters that he brings in. I know even if they're based off of like existing characters, the way he mashes them in so well, it's pretty clever.
Mm-hmm.
People are gonna hate what he did to Harry Potter, but considering current events, like, I don't know how far have you? All right, so you've never read it before, or
I have never the League of Extraordinary Gentlemen before.
Okay. I wouldn't say spoilers, but Harry Potter is in it, but not in the way you would think. I'll say that much.
Wait, what?
Harry Potter's in it. Not by name. But you could definitely tell what Alan Moore is a very, very angry inside boy. So it's like when you get to a certain point in the LXG comics, you will see Harry Potter in there.
God.
He doesn't like, he really doesn't like Harry Potter. Alan Moore prefers like the old literary classics more.
No. I can understand.
It's funny though the way he builds them up.
Yeah, I love it that he incorporated such characters like Alan Quartermain, Rodney Skinner,
Holly Griffin. That, oh god, when you get to all the times that you've probably heard Cryptic, like, you know, cracking jokes about Patrick being, you know, having like a very hell of a boss style attitude for comedy wise, or like Homer Simpson. No. Mm-hmm. When you get to Holly Griffin, the Invisible Man, there's your Patrick. Yeah, yeah. That's your Patrick. That is the Patrick I'm going for. There's a bit where I guess it's not really spoilers per se, but I'll leave it up to you. They catch Holly Griffin at the Wayward School, for girls, and they think he's a ghost I don't think I should say anymore because it would get me demonetized, but
no,
very adult idea. Let's just say he takes advantage of that place using his newfound ability.
I mean in his position, because he's a criminal, especially considering the fact that he's invisible, and that is just wrong.
I would go so far to say as Beverly is a bookworm, and that is how she sees Patrick, Holly Griffin, fucking the Invisible Man, just in and out, and it's just like, yeah.
Honestly, I love Rodney Skinner way better.
Oh, man. Was that the one from the movie, or no?
Yeah, that's the one from the movie.
I haven't seen that movie in so long. The last thing I watched from that was the last resemblance of something talking about that was Lost in Adaptation, that one YouTube channel that like looks at like movie adaptations of books or television show versions of that book.
Yeah, it's interesting to see like the differences there.
I legitimately
I kind of like the differences they did, and it makes sense to make Dorian the traitor rather than the Invisible Man.
I'll be honest, I really didn't like the movie. Like, I mean, looking back, I think I don't mind watching it. I will watch it again because it's dumb, silly action. It's Expendables, but with literary characters. But it's so cheesy. It's a 2000s like action movie that I think probably would have even made more sense if it came out in the 90s. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like it's a movie that feels 10 years out of time.
It's bland specifically because they focused less on action and stuff, like what would be done in most superhero films, and it focuses way too much on just conversation and discussing things.
Yeah, kind of like Star Wars Episode 1. Yeah, like I told Zach about it. It's like that Blark and Son video. Hey, George, you got to make... we need you to direct the Star Wars movie. You need to make it about trade disputes. People want to see trade disputes.
I mean, seriously, why? Because realistically, like, I can understand wanting to go in a different direction since it is prequel films, but really? Fucking really?
Maybe, you know what, just for a sense of closure, we should stream that movie. I think that would be a good movie to watch, just so I can kind of cringe. It has its merits. I liked Hyde in that movie, and I liked the Invisible Man in that movie, and Mina Harker's alright, but it's set up in such a very 2000s Expendables action hero ensemble. Oh, and Tom Sawyer. It's got Tom Sawyer in it in that ridiculous ass car.
Yeah. Oh, and God. Furthermore, you can easily tell who the villain is going to be right off the bat.
Yeah, let's be real. Was there any guess who was going to be Moriarty? Yeah.
Yep. I do think it was funny that Dante was there and...
I don't want to give away who the villain is in the comic. I mean, they're not off. I think it's in the same in the comic books, but Moriarty also has Alan Moore also doesn't like James Bond. So even James Bond is part of the villainous group. They have to call him Campion Bond and Jimmy Bond and J6, J2, obviously for copyright reasons. But he has like a moment where
they made James Bond a villain though, because that just doesn't really make that much sense.
Well, it'll make sense when you read it, is what I'll say. It'll make more sense once you kind of like read it through and kind of follow along. It'll come to you. But yeah, Alan Moore hates fun things. Yeah, it's like I agree with Alan Moore in some degree with how he sees modern cinema now these days, but the same is like, I'm like, come on, man. James Bond's awesome. I like James Bond. I
feel like you. You know, the league.
Your audio's cutting out so bad. Your audio's cutting out so bad.
Oh, shice.
Yeah.
Well, it's not too bad, is it?
It's working now. Yeah, okay. It's working now. Earlier, though, it was like hard to tell. But yeah, yeah, go ahead, as you were saying. Now it's cutting out. Yeah, now it's cutting out. Right, these shoes will be the death of me. I don't even think I did this right. I don't know if this is a good...
Yeah. Shoes are always really difficult when you're trying to draw characters.
He's got shoes worse. That kind of look like high heels. So it's like, I can't... That's why I always draw. That's why, like, if you look over here, I always give my characters these generic ass shoes.
Yeah.
Yeah, because like I can't do no fucking high heels. I was like, are you mad? I can't do that.
Anyway, I did notice some interesting names in the members of the league, like Alice Liddell is one of them.
Oh, the story behind her and Alex in the comics is very. Very sad. Very sad.
Yeah, I remember reading something about that.
Yeah, it goes into detail on the wiki. Oh, I feel so bad for her. Oh, God.
Yeah. Then one other name that I noticed that actually was Babar.
When you get to the Dr. Moreau part, you could definitely see more of Keeping Up's influence. That's another thing that was also my favorite part. It's implied that a lot of these early Anthro characters in children's literature came from Dr. Moreau.
Okay, that's really cool.
Yeah, from Babar to Rupert the Bear to Wind in the Willows. Like, that part I love so much. And... not to delay the stream, but that was something I wanted to happen in my comic as well in Keep Up. Like, I want to make a character that would be kind of inspired by Dr. Moreau, who's trying to find, like, the hidden link between, like, the scientist in Keep Up. He's aware that there's talking animals, but there's also, you know, regular animals. So you got Patrick the Mouse, and then you got a mouse, and he's trying to find like the distinction between that. And there would be a whole story arc where it wouldn't involve Patrick and Vinny, or maybe Patrick and who's somebody's mic is really loud. Sorry, Wes, I gotta tone you down a little bit.
It's Wes's.
Yeah.
Hello, I'm sorry.
It's fine. But in the comic, it would be yeah, there's a lot of reverb. I'm sorry, Wes. That's loud. Yeah, it's fine. So the scientist is trying to find like this the distinct link between like anthro and human and why we got this and that. But he takes it to a whole other level when either Patrick and Beverly and Vinny discover that he's, in doing so, he's pulling very Dr. Moreau-styled experiments. So they go, they wind up going to like his, not an island, but like his, some kind of like section up in the UK. And they find him trying to mesh, like, can we make human anthros? Like, what happens if I put this into this guy? And he's trying to make, like, tiger-human hybrids. He wants to create his own anthro, but they come out so, so wrong. So I want to give, keep up this weird Dr. Moreau vibe where it's like, Beverly's, you know, like, Beverly being there's like, my God, it's an abomination. There's this guy's... You know, he's got the anthro mice, yeah, but it's like, but what if we can make that further? We can make a human mouse, you know, 6 feet. I took my underling and performed the experiments on him, combined the DNA, stitched him together from pot, you know, and Beverly's just mortified by the, like, I want to do that, you know, just bring in that weird, scary body horror shit and to keep up, you know, it's like...
Always good to throw in some subgenres in.
Yeah. Okay, this is also not particularly a good... Okay, I think that can do it. Just make a position more down like that. Okay. Not perfect. I can always fix that in post, huh? But, yeah, it's like, oh. Because I want to do it's like an episodic series where it's like Patrick, Vinny, and Beverly in their own adventures, either taking on challenges, dealing with, you know, Patrick taking on other criminals, people trying to like... Because the whole crux of the reboot is that, okay, Patrick is now number one, but how is he going to maintain that? Well, he's got to take on all these challengers. Now there's people that want to be like, yeah, I could be the next Patrick, you know, shit like that.
Yeah, that's fair.
Let's see. I might take a break because my mind is kind of like really derpy trying to figure this out.
No.
But I'm glad you guys showed up. This is actually a lot of fun. Like, I want to do more of this. Okay, I think it's like more wine right here. And then...
All right, I better get going. I gotta get on my homework anyway.
All right, I'll be around if you need me. I'll be on VR chat with Mikey. Probably in like the next 30 minutes or something like that, and I'll tell you how that goes. Maybe we can hang out later. We could do some gaming together or whatever you want to do.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Maybe I can stream some stuff to you.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind that. All right. Let me leave this on a high note.
About that? Maybe I can stream some stuff to you over the PlayStation because I did get some new games too.
All right, sure. We can do that.
All right. I'll see you later.
All right. See you, man. Have a good one. Let's see. He's got, like... I'll figure this out. My mind's, like, derp right now. All right. See, Wes is... No, Wes is not there anymore. Okay. But, going back to what I was saying earlier, I wanted two more of these streams, though. I'm sorry that I spent more time rambling than actually drawing. It was good to have company. Last time I made the mistake of streaming while my friends were playing games, so there wasn't very much attendee. So I'm really glad that Wes and Final Draft showed up for this one. Not much to, like, okay, I don't know if maybe I'll do, like, if you guys are okay with another part to this, I can, there's another part to this, if you want, I can just, I'll do a time skip, I'll come back and, color this out, and, or, like, at least fix the stuff that I'm trying to fix, and, I'll be back with you guys soon, and we'll just jump right ahead, and you guys watch me add, like, the finishing touches, because I don't think you guys want to see me, like, constantly fretting over these minor details. But all right, I will I'll put this up on YouTube, and I will catch you guys real soon. What do you think? What do you think, guys? It looks all right. Looks all right. It's not perfect, but it'll do. All right, I'll see you guys on the next stream. Catch you guys later. See y'all on VR chat. Have a good night.